Uh-oh. I knew it. I knew
which
it.
Which you suspected the whole time. The question is which one.
Yeah, I know. That's...
the collective heroes who brought us Mark Echoes getting up, contents under pressure. Oh boy, gotta connect the DualShocks.
Yep.
Yeah!
Episode 3. The planet Mordor gives it away.
Yeah. Did you ever play this one?
I haven't, actually.
This one is actually a very, very competent character action game. It's not amazing, but it's decent. It's not awful.
Yeah.
So, and it kind of diverges from the narrative of the movie just a little bit. Takes a more creative approach to it.
Well, that's good.
And, yeah, it's actually pretty fun. It also has one of the best multiplayer, like, it's literal actual has its own fighting game.
Yeah, I did play the multiplayer mode.
Yeah.
I've just never played the actual, like, campaign of the game.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, with the new movie coming out in less than a month at the time of recording, I thought we'd sit down and play some game. And
some more quality Star
about,
Wars.
Yeah, talk about Star Wars.
Yeah, so...
Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun.
So I guess it goes without saying, all films out up until this point are fair game. All stuff that's no longer canon is fair game.
Yeah. Oh,
and
yeah,
we will be shit-talking the hell out of Episode 7.
Yeah. we're getting in there. It's going to happen. So, yeah. High sodium levels inbound.
Yes. Oh, God.
Be prepared. Yeah, I'm just going to use my save that I already got all the shit unlocked. And,
that's fine.
And, yeah, just do it. Alright, rescue over course, so you play as Anakin Skywalker.
Oh, look at that slow text scroll.
Yeah. Yep.
Well, there's a scroll option, so.
On the Outer Rim to stop the plot.
Of the general griefer.
Yep.
He's been fucking up all of our Minecraft servers.
So I checked earlier, and you cannot skip the cutscenes.
Oh.
Well, you can skip the cutscenes, but if you do, it just dumps you right into the level. It's not, like, a segmented.
Okay.
This does use some movie footage, so I am interested to see if and what gets flagged for content ID.
Oh, that's a good point, yeah.
But, not that I really give that much a shit, because we're not making money anyway. So.
Yeah, to be fair, yeah, we're not.
Yeah.
We're not robbing anyone at the moment.
But we're gonna get into it. Prequels, yeah. Sequels,
squeakles,
prequels. War. The Republic is crumbling under the assault of George Lucas.
Not anymore. Now it's Walt Disney. Oh my God.
The even more sinister.
Oh my God.
Side.
So I don't know if I ever I saw Tomorrowland when it was in theaters, and some people get that movie shit. So you know, I won't put my opinions on the movie in there. But at one point, you know, it's a Disney film. The main character goes into a comic book store, like a nerd store, and the first thing you see on camera is a fucking Rebel flight suit.
Oh.
Like, Disney was just like, ha, we own Star Wars now! And I'm just like, son of a bitch, Disney!
Oh, I don't... Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ugh, God.
Yeah. See, this is the best part neither of us wants to talk about Star Wars, because we're so bitter.
Well, it's been ruined forever.
Let's just get into it. Okay. Yeah. Prequels are pretty bad, guys. They're kind of bad.
There were some okay moments, and if you watch the Phantom edit on YouTube, it makes it a surprisingly good, like, movie.
Here we get the abridged cutscene of the opening of none of the shit with the clones. You're just going to Grievous' ship,
yep.
And, well, have you noticed the shields are still up?
Yeah.
The General's command ship is dead ahead.
Yep. Yep, R2 booth.
Yep, that'll flag the content ID.
Yep, the best part of the prequels, Ewan McGregor and Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Oh, he does such a good job.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's funny, I tried the game out early just to make sure the disc works.
Yeah, sure, sure.
This is actually on PSN as a classic.
Is it really?
Apparently.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, but this is my old PS2 copy. 2005.
Wow.
We're old.
Holy shit, that was a lot. That's fucking 10 years ago.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's funny. I'm pretty sure Obi-Wan's voice stuff is all done by Ewan McGregor.
Yeah, I'm gonna look.
But I don't know if Hayden Christensen did any of Anakin's stuff, because if he did, the line reading is terrible for Anakin.
Well, to be fair,
I know Obi-Wan's is really good. Like, it's surprisingly great how good his lines are. Like, Ewan McGregor fucking knocked it out if it was him. If not, it's a very, very, very convincing sound alike.
Well, yeah, Ewan McGregor did such a good job in the film. Well, yeah. He studied the original trilogy to get all, like, the mannerisms and shit down.
Yeah. So you could be Obi-Wan.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna check on some voice work then.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, this is a pretty good character action. You got lights, you got heavies, you got the square, 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 and the triangle, triangle,
yeah.
Triangle.
Your basic combos.
Force love powers, you got, deflect their fire. Saber dueling. It's definitely one of the better Star Wars wings out there. Got some really good power attacks.
Well, considering
I got all this shit unlocked since I already,
yeah.
Done this shit. And I have most of the secrets unlocked already, so. Another junk pile. R2
needs some cover. Protect the R2.
Yeah, protect the R2. Attacks against those super battle droids. Those super battle droids. Something I don't know. That'll help. Yeah, he didn't, because voice acting, this is terrible if it's him. I'm pretty sure it's them, because this was, like, so licensed and
yeah.
Everything. I think they got them to cut all the lines.
I was just on Ewan McGregor's Wikipedia,
and
I didn't see it, but I'm going on the actual games
thing, yeah, to see who.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it's him.
It sounds like him,
like really, really.
Yeah, you know what? Let me just go to IMDb. Actually, probably a better idea. Halt, cut him in half.
Yep. Halt. Roger.
Well, some of the best Star Wars games ever are the Lego ones.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah. And like, when I play this game, like this game does a much better job of like presenting the episode 3 story.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Cuz like we still have a mission to complete. The pacing's way better cuz like you're actually playing through a whole level and shit
and it's not just trying to jar you through this in like 15 minutes.
Yeah, and there's some narrative changes. You'll get to see how shit happens. It's slightly changed. Thank Christ there's like no Padme in this fucking game.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, fuck. Like that fucking love story is the worst part of that.
Well, the problem is they didn't write it correctly. If they would have written it better, then it would have worked way better.
Mm-hmm.
But they didn't.
Yeah,
and that's something the Phantom Edit does really well, is they make that story way better.
Yeah, because it just focuses on what needs to actually be said.
Yeah. Alright, I'm not finding anything anywhere on him doing it. I mean, maybe he did and it's just not up on anything. And again, it sounds like him.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Whatever. We can just assume it's Ewan McGregor.
I'm pretty sure it really sounds like him. And some of Anakin's lines sound like Hayden Christensen.
Yeah.
Some of them are just really flat readings, though. Like, if it's him, like, some of them he just phoned in super hard.
Yeah. We don't have time to play around here. But,
like, that sounds like Ewan McGregor.
That does sound really close.
I'm pretty sure it's that. But yeah, Anakin's lines are... Oh, they're so bad. You don't even...
Anakin was never... As far as dialogue is concerned, his dialogue for the prequels were not written well at all.
I kind of feel bad for Hayden Christensen, because, like... He kind of screwed him as an actor.
He's not a bad actor. I've seen him in other stuff.
Yeah.
That he's, like, pretty good in.
Just, like, Lucas didn't really... He doesn't give good direction for acting.
No, not at all.
Yeah. I watch all Plinkett's reviews for Star Wars.
Okay, yeah.
Look at this more believable CG than the actual movie.
Oh my god, I know.
It's reconstruction of cutscenes from the movie.
That is the that's the worst part about the prequel trilogy is the CG is so bad most of the time.
Yeah. So funnily enough, I don't remember if this is because it's like New Game Plus, but Anakin just has Force Lightning. Whereas Obi-Wan has, like, the mind
I remember trick. that he, like, gets that.
I don't know if it switches halfway through or not. I can't remember, but I feel like Anakin wouldn't just start with Force Lightning.
Well, no.
If it was like that, that's really dumb. I know.
Well, that's the best part, too, is, like, they do that kind of bullshit, but you never see Anakin or Darth Vader use Force Lightning.
Yeah. Yeah, it was Sidious's thing. Yeah, he was the one with the evil magic shit.
Yeah. Anakin. I could use your help here. And then, of course, Jesus, listen to the fan on your PlayStation 3.
Oh my god, yeah, this is an original edition PlayStation 3, by the way.
it's a spaceship.
This never died. Everyone's 360s died. My original PlayStation 3 never died.
That's impressive. My original PlayStation 3 did die, actually.
Well, yeah, and this is the backwards compatible model, too.
Yeah. But yeah, like, it was Sidious' thing, and then, like, the extended universe occurred back, when that used to be canon.
But yeah, like, and yeah, too, so like, how, like, narrative has evolved. You know, originally the thing was that, like, Force Lightning was supposed to be a corruption of the Force. It was evil as shit. It was, you know, dark magic shit.
Yeah.
But then, like, people thought about it and was like, well, no, there's nothing inherently evil about lightning. Like, I don't get
yeah,
it.
Yeah, and, but then...
It's like, how do you use the Force is what should define you as good or evil.
Well, and that's where the justification for that came through of, Force Lightning needed to be this intense focus on, like, anger and passion and, like, emotional stuff.
Yeah, like lightning.
Yeah, exactly. Like, and that's, and, you know...
Being angry doesn't necessarily make you a bad person.
Well, yeah, but the Jedi were, you know... The Jedi became as wrong as the Sith in their lack of any kind of
emotion.
Well,
yeah, when the one... This is all extended universe bullshit, so if you're all scratching your heads, go fuck yourself.
Yeah.
But, yeah, when the Jedi Order, that one master, like, redid the code and, like...
He fucked
totally
it all up.
Made them super conservative assholes.
He turned them into fucking, like, celibate monks is what
yeah.
he did.
And it's like, no, that was a terrible idea. Why would you do that to us?
Yeah, like...
Fucking ass.
But, and because that's the thing, too, is, like... Sure, the Sith, you know, the Sith have a lust for power or whatever, but it's not like evil intentions are
yeah,
what you need
that
for their
power's lesser.
No.
It's just that their path is easier to take to give in to
oh,
your
yeah.
emotion is
yeah.
much easier than controlling
All I'm saying
yourself.
Is this, you can't say that's the lesser path when the fucking thought bomb exists.
Yeah,
and you can
yeah,
just
yeah.
kill
yeah,
all the Force users on a planet? Like,
did you know that the Jedi have committed atrocities also?
Yeah.
yeah. It's almost like organizations can be really fucking terrible.
Yeah.
Well,
like did you ever read the Darth Bane books when they came out?
No.
Okay. Well, I did. And the Jedi General leading the army at the time that right before Bane destroyed the Sith and started the Rule of Two
yeah.
was a fucking asshole. Mm. Like, he was just the worst.
R2, stay here so we don't have to animate you through the rest of the yes. movie and slash game. But, yeah. That's the... The first little mission done right there. So, yep, I already maxed all this shit out. This whole middle era of licensed movie games like this and the Lord of the Rings games were like
oh, yeah.
super competent, like licensing things.
The Lord of the Rings Return of the King video game is the best Lord of the Rings game ever made.
Like, oh my
that
god.
That game is amazing.
Oh boy.
Immediately followed by Lego Lord of the Rings.
Exactly. Now we gotta play as the Obi-Wan. Best character in Star Wars, hands down, you can all fight me. Fuck all of you. Obi-Wan Kenobi. It's the General Grievous.
Well, remember.
He's got the George Lucas cough.
Yeah, he does. Well, remember, Obi-Wan Kenobi visits a brothel in every system.
Yeah.
He's actually the worst Jedi ever. He's
well, yeah, in so much as, like, the code. And,
yeah, as far as the code's concerned.
Yeah.
You know, he's always cutting people's arms off in bars and shit.
Yeah. But, no, Obi-Wan Kenobi, best...
He's super strong.
He's such a competent swordsman, you know, he's just fucking awesome. He's Obi-Wan, fuck you.
He's one of the few Jedi that I, like, genuinely enjoy.
Yeah. I'm not worried. This will be no problem. Did I say I was worried? I did, like, some of these dumb scenes. Okay, now I'm worried.
Yeah. Nah.
Did you see the extended scene of that where they're doing the stupid motions to
yeah.
each other?
Yeah, I'll twirl my mustache. Oh, that scene's so dumb.
Yeah, and Shakti's corpse is on the ground, but then the Force Unleashed came out, and they retconned that deleted scene.
Oh my
scene
god.
And
I fucking hate the Force Unleashed.
Yeah, it wasn't great.
Well, the games were garbage, and the narrative was terrible. And then
so the best part about Obi-Wan is he's acrobatic as fuck in this game. Yeah, and so, combat. We haven't talked much about the game.
Yeah, we've actually just been talking about Star Wars.
Like, each button I'm pressed, if you, like, hold the button, you'll do, like, force application to the move. Like,
okay.
Better hits.
Yeah.
This Obi-Wan Roundhouse is the dirtiest shit ever.
Oh my
especially
god.
Especially in the fighting game. Obi-Wan is so fucking good in the
That's
dueling
funny.
Stuff.
That's awesome.
Oh my god, he's so godlike. But, yeah, what were we saying? Force Unleashed, yeah. Wow, what a misuse of the property.
Well, and that's the problem, too.
Like, it could have been so much better.
Well, and the issue is, one of the dumbest things about the narrative is, like, oh, well, Darth Sidious created the Rebel Alliance to smoke out the Rebels, and then it was his downfall. It's like, listen, Darth Sidious got real dumb. Palpatine got real dumb after he got into power, and I acknowledge that. But after reading the book that came out, you know, back before they made all that shit non-canon,
yeah.
about Palpatine's rise to becoming a Sith, he should have never made that kind
Not
of mistake.
Sense.
That
yeah.
narrative has no right existing.
Yeah. As if it's like George Lucas is a terrible writer.
Well, yeah. Well, that's the problem, is all the extended universe shit is way better written than the movies.
Yeah. Yeah, it's great how they declared all that shit non-canon, and I guarantee a bunch of the movie, episode 7 is going to use a bunch of, like, plot lines from
Oh,
that
fuck
shit.
Yeah.
Like, people are already, like, guessing, and, like, spoilers, if you don't want to hear about the movie and shit, like, you know, that's, I don't know what you want me to do, but, like, you know, I don't know, it's not a confirmed thing.
But it's stuff that you can infer.
If you don't want to hear shit about it, like, don't. But, like, from the trailers, people have seen, like, there's the scene where Han's holding Leia and, like, they're, like, crying and shit. And, like, people think, like, Chewbacca's gonna die.
Yeah.
And, like, some people said they think Han's gonna die and shit. But, like, Chewbacca died like a fucking pimp in the extended universe.
Oh, yeah.
And, like, now they're gonna give him a shitty death now, probably.
Yeah.
It's gonna fucking
suck. Oh, did you hear that Leia is getting a new title in the movie?
You know, what, like, Jedi...
General.
Oh, she's General Leia now?
Yeah, she's becoming General Leia.
Even though she... was a general before?
The, like, shut up, though.
No, the princess, though.
No, not anymore, because Alderaan's dead, though.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
There we go.
That was dirty as fuck.
I remember how to target with your force power.
The force throw, yeah.
I hate their robes. I get that, like, the robes, like, added flowing motion to their, like, character design and shit. But, like, fighting in a robe is awful.
Yeah, that's a bad idea.
Yeah.
You notice how Darth Maul removed his robe when he was dueling?
Yeah. Well, like any of the serious duels, yeah, they always remove the robes, because, like, you know, you gotta get serious.
The last thing you need is for your fucking saber to get caught on.
Yeah. Well, like, it just fucking drags. It's awful.
Yeah, it's...
Yeah, you gotta rotate the stick. Yep. There you go. Forget how to do the fucking launchers in this game. It does have a pretty decent combo system and shit.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I said, this is, like, a really competent
one. Yeah, no, it looks like it's actually really well done.
Sure as hell better than the Star Wars Obi-Wan game.
Oh!
That game is B-A-D bad with a capital B and an A.
Oh my god, that shit is so bad. Yeah, well, I mean, think about it. So let's talk about some good Star Wars games, and, you know, we'll talk more about the movies as we go through this.
Yeah.
So this game is good.
Yeah.
The KOTOR games are good.
Yeah. Shadows of the Empire.
Shadows of the Empire. There was that fucking really old FPS... we play as a trooper. I fucking forget what it's called.
Like, how old are we talking? Like, a couple years?
No, like, we're talking before this game.
Yeah, I don't
remember what it's called. I'm gonna actually look some of this up while we're talking about it.
Yeah,
But
Republic Commando was actually pretty good.
That's one that was really good. Yeah, was good. Maybe Battlefront, the first two Battlefronts, obviously.
Yeah.
Lego Star Wars was good.
Yeah, Star Wars has had pretty consistent, decent stuff. I didn't much care for the RTSs. They weren't that great.
No, they weren't really well done.
Yeah, use the Force to bridge the gap.
Yeah, I wasn't huge into the RTSs.
Yep, just gonna shake with the palsy.
Yep. Did you ever play... There was an arcade game that played through the... Oh, man.
Yeah,
they used to have their shit at the movie theater near us. Mm-hmm. Oh, that game's amazing. Let's see. Episode-related titles.
Dark Forces, Jedi Academy.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
There's actually a lot of really good Star Wars games.
Thinking about it? Yeah, you're right. Actually, there was a pinball game, apparently.
There you go. Again, with the big Force push.
There's the
launcher.
Okay, so a lot of these episode-associated ones, I don't even know because they came out on, like, the Atari and shit.
Yeah. And those ones are...
And I've, like, never played them.
The Super Nintendo games weren't great, but they weren't bad either.
Yeah.
They just had a lot of, like, game design jank from being in...
Yeah,
old
yeah.
Alright.
Pod Racing was amazing.
Yeah.
For what it was.
For
it was dumb.
It was, yeah.
It was dumb, but
it was
fun.
It was dumb multiplayer fun, yeah.
Yeah.
In that it was a fun game to play with your friends or whatever.
Yeah.
And then you gotta move left and right to...
They made a Star Wars Episode 2 for the Game Boy Advance. I didn't know that.
Yeah. This game had a Game Boy.
That I do know. That I do know. That I remember.
Yeah, and then I think the PSP version of this got fucking shit canned.
Probably.
I sense something. That means there's a secret.
Clone Wars.
I'm not doing that bullshit because I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, right. Rogue Squadron.
Yeah,
that's the one I was thinking of.
Yeah.
I never played the second or third one. I didn't even know they made sequels. But I played the first one.
I don't think they were as great.
They were on the GameCube.
Yeah.
But I did play the first Rogue Squadron, and the first one's great.
Yeah.
I loved the first one.
Woo! I forgot about that.
Jedi Starfighter.
Yeah, Starfighter was
pretty okay. It was okay.
Yeah.
Dark Forces.
Dark Forces is fucking awesome.
Was fucking awesome, yeah.
Jedi Academy is fucking great.
That game's amazing. Battlefront and Battlefront 2 again are great.
Yeah.
I'm
waiting for new Battlefront.
New Battlefront's gonna be Garbo.
Yeah.
KOTOR.
God, John Williams' fucking music is so good.
What a man. What a fucking man. I'm glad they, like, put that in here. KOTOR.
Oh, look at that frame rate shit, the bed.
Right. KOTOR and KOTOR 2 were both really good. I really like them.
If KOTOR 2's ending got botched to shit.
Oh, well, yeah, that was the problem. You know, back in the golden age of BioWare.
Yeah.
You know, back when they made
their game. Before they got bought out by EA. Get fucked. Oh, no, not one of them droids.
The buzz droids. Oh, shit, the flood.
Mumpkin, help yourself. Obi-Wan's get the best dumb one-liners.
Oh, they're so good.
Yeah, the dumb thing about these things, you can just use the Force Influence bullshit to insta-kill them.
That's hilarious. That's so broken.
Yeah.
But, yeah, like, BioWare back before... And again, I told you, right around the time EA really fucked with them and they switched the whole writing staff, Dragon Age Origins was great.
Yeah.
Mass Effect was great. Mass Effect 2 was okay. Dragon Age 2, Dragon Age Inquisition, Mass Effect 3 are all garbage.
Yeah.
The writing's fucking terrible. But yeah, the KOTOR games were good. They made that MMO, which was kind of weird.
The first MMO was good.
Yes, you're right.
Galaxies
was good. The new one.
Yeah.
Old Republic is not good. Not good. So the Force Unleashed games are terrible. Funny story about that. I might have told you before. So... I played through the Force Unleashed with a friend on their, like, PlayStation... version, right? And
do the indie.
Yeah, nailed woo! It. And then I got a chance to play the Wii version with the super shitty lightsaber
that
you throw your Wiimote in.
That feels bad.
Man, did that play like
that
garbage.
Feels bad.
Man, did that play like garbage.
Ooh.
It's so bad.
That's dirty.
It felt dirty.
And Force of Leech could have been... Could have been better. Like, if they had chosen a better way to go about the story.
If they had written a better overall story, and then, of course, there was... The way that they ended it was so dumb.
Yeah, and then...
So dumb.
And then they didn't even have the balls to, like, stick with it, and then in the second one, they, like, changed a bunch of shit.
Oh, yeah,
and, like,
I know.
That was...
And they ended it more dumb.
Yeah.
And then, obviously, the LEGO Star Wars games were great.
Yeah, they're really, really good.
Yeah. But yeah, there's been plenty of Star Wars games.
Yeah.
And a lot of them have actually been pretty good.
Yeah.
Star Wars is one of the few series that has good licensing.
Yeah.
Because, like for instance, Lord of the Rings, Return of the King was really good, Lego Lord of the Rings is really good,
yeah.
And Shadows of Mordor is, like, okay.
Yeah.
Most of the Lord
Two
of the Rings...
Towers one was all
okay.
Right, but it only had, like, three characters. This is the thing, is Return of the King was a vast improvement on everything about it.
Oh, yeah.
Not, like,
yeah.
In comparison, it's just, like...
Not fair. Yeah.
But, yeah, Battle for Middle Earth games were pretty decent.
Yeah, those were good RTSs.
Yeah, but then, like, there was the Third Age RPG one, there's the MMO, it wasn't great.
The North,
yeah,
or the North, or whatever.
The North, yeah.
Yeah, Lord of the Rings didn't have good with licensing. Harry Potter video games were terrible in
yeah.
licensing, like, really bad.
I did have a Harry Potter Game Boy Advance game. I think it was Chamber of Secrets. That was kind of fun, just because it was mostly, like, a collect-a-thon.
Yeah.
And I haven't, like, gotten to play one of those in forever.
The handheld versions were more collect-a-thons,
yeah.
But I had the first... I had,
You had console...
I had PC version of Sorcerer's Stone and Chamber of Secrets. Woof.
Yeah.
I never played any after that.
Yeah.
I had been considering playing the Lego ones, because they're probably good.
Yeah,
but,
I'm sure they're fine.
But, because the Lego games usually... But yeah, like, a lot of other ones have terrible licensing. You know, Spider-Man didn't get great licensing.
Spooderman
2.
Jeez, that's another series of, like, hit and miss. Like,
Spooderman 2, where your web actually connects
yeah,
to the
well,
buildings.
That's the thing that makes or breaks this game, is the web swinging good? If
yeah.
not, then it's shit.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Spooderman didn't get really good licensing.
No, yeah.
But, yeah, the Star Wars was fairly consistent. Fairly consistent.
Yeah.
Obi-Wan's.
Yep.
But, yeah, I mean... That's the thing about us doing this, is, like, this game is good, and Star Wars used to be really fucking awesome, and it's gonna get ruined forever.
Yeah, yeah, sure, let's get into it. So, new movie.
It's just gonna be the Star Trek reboot. You
yeah,
could see it
yeah.
evident in all the trailers. It's just going to be all the same cinematography and ideas used for the Star Trek reboot.
Well, yeah, we've talked about this a couple times, but, like, we'll reiterate here, like, there is no... Star, there's nothing in space. Where are the star battles? It's
yeah.
Star Wars. There should be space battles.
Yep.
Like, come on, guys.
Well, yeah, and that's the problem with the new Battlefront, is there's no space battles.
Yeah, but yeah, it's fucking J.J. Abrams has, like, one design, or, like...
Style. He has one style.
And, you know, I don't think that works very well with fucking Star Wars. Star Wars is not fast-paced action bullshit.
No, Star Wars is a lot about the story.
Yeah.
Like, a lot.
It's, you know, philosophical, it's, you know, even if the prequel movies have the fucking... terrible, like, hours of just political dialogue bullshit going on.
It's like Metal Gear, give me my geopolitical bullshit.
Yeah, like, and some people like that. Like, I was never bothered by that kind of shit.
No.
But, like, could it have been done better than, like, a 30-minute still shot of just people talking? Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit. But you gotta Qui-Gon it. You gotta do the Qui-Gon.
There we go.
Qui-Gon Jinn was another amazing Jedi character.
Yeah. You know, it's a good thing Liam Neeson never read that script, or else he wouldn't have been in that movie.
Oh, fuck no. Sucked. Yeah. The best part about that is Liam Neeson being on Star Wars Episode 1 increased the budget so much. Not like for paying for Liam Neeson.
Yeah.
Because of how they did it, the sets were built to the height of their actors. And yeah. Liam Neeson's so goddamn tall, they had to build all of the sets bigger.
Yeah, he's dude. Always on the move.
The lip sync on that was awful.
Yeah, it's pretty rough. Yep, just stand in the hole.
Don't worry about
stand
it.
In the hole,
don't you fucking worry about it.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah, I can't bring myself to think that that movie's gonna be good. I just know they're gonna have.
Well, and the thing that baffles me is, you know, they get the rights to this franchise. They shut down, you know, fucking LucasArts.
Yeah,
they,
kill fucking the Boba Fett game.
Yeah.
Thanks, assholes.
Yeah, they shut down LucasArts. They make the entire extended universe non-canon. I'm sorry,
yeah, shit.
Legends.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
Yeah, shit all over the existing fan base.
And, you know, they literally had... There was literally...
I do like these
stories designs. That is super cool, actually. I like that. There was literally 6 more movies already written for them.
Yeah.
In addition to the extended universe. Like, sure, they could have taken creative liberties. That's fine. Why did you scrap all that? There was established story.
The reason is simple. It's because Harrison Ford and them are old as shit. And that shit took place at a
immediately
time when those
after.
Characters were younger.
Yeah.
So it would be jarring as shit. Now, could they have changed the dates around a little bit and, like, worked with it? Yeah, but I think the thing is that Disney didn't want them to be written into a fucking corner. By, like, already established. They want them to invite their own new shit so we can have our own new toys and our own new series and yada fucking yada. And it's just like, come on.
We want our own planets of Ewoks.
Although I will say, turning lemons into lemonade. Have you watched any of the Clone Wars cartoon? Like, not the cartoon, the CG.
I never finished it. I started off when it first started airing. That's surprisingly good.
Yeah, there is some good shit in that. And, like, okay, a lot of people complain about Ahsoka. Yeah, she's annoying. And, like, why does Anakin have an apprentice out of nowhere?
Yeah.
But, have you seen any of Star Wars Rebels, the new...
Yes,
thing?
I have.
Yeah, like, they brought Ahsoka back in that, and, like, they actually made her, like, an actual interesting character.
Yeah, no, those...
Like, that's actually being handled kind of well. I'm kind of surprised about that.
Are you still out there?
Oh, hold on. I can just power move these fucking guys to death.
But, yeah, no, that's what I've noticed, because I've seen a little bit of each of those series. I've seen most of Clone Wars.
Yeah.
Just, I missed a little bit of it.
Unfortunately about that, it's all out of chronological fucking order, so if you want to, like, watch it in a semi-good, decent, like, way of knowing what the fuck's going on,
yeah.
You gotta, like, start with, like, some episodes from season 2.
Yeah, it's weird.
It's like, oh, come on, guys, really?
But, yeah, I made it through most of that. I just didn't have, like, I just never got around to, like, finishing it.
Mm-hmm.
And I watched the first couple episodes of Rebels when it first started, and yeah, those series are surprisingly good.
Yeah.
Especially I was very pleased with how, like, decent Rebels was.
Yeah. So.
But. The controls are down. Yeah, it's just like, and then of course, like, what really jars me is, like, there's, like, these people who are apparently, like, huge Star Wars fans, and they're like, oh yeah, I can't wait for the new movie. It's like, really? Have you, like, been
looking at it
at all?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't think it's gonna be that great. Like, and especially, I think it's being overhyped way too much.
Well, and so here's the thing too. It's done by J.J. Abrams, and you can tell by looking at the trailers that he's doing it like he did the Star Trek reboots. Now, I don't know how much Star Trek you've consumed in your life.
Pretty decent amount.
I consumed a good amount because my dad loves it, and I kind of, you know, I enjoy it too. I don't like the reboots of Star Trek.
Yeah.
I'm not a, like, they're not bad, but I'm not a huge fan. And I wouldn't say that they're, like, anything, like, amazing. Yeah. Like, they're okay at best, you know? And
yeah, they're decent action flicks, I guess, but they're not great Star Wars.
Well, yeah.
Star Trek.
Yeah, they're not, like, they're not, well, that's, it's films. The same thing. They're not what Star Trek was.
Yeah.
Star Trek
is philosophical,
it's a sci-fi
jargon,
yeah,
bullshit.
It's a, Star Trek is a sci-fi exploration thing.
Yeah.
And they made it an action movie, and that's why it didn't, like, work out nearly as well.
Let's head back to the elevators.
You know? And they're going to do the same thing with Star Wars. Star Wars is not, like, an action movie.
Yeah. But no, it's going to be high-flying, flutin' bullshit.
Yeah.
But, yeah, predictions. Kylo Ren will be a terrible, terrible character. And people say he's fucking Luke Skywalker. Which, if it does turn out that he is Luke Skywalker wants his dark side, I'm immediately calling him the fuck out on just ripping off
the story.
Universe.
Because Luke does go to the dark side for a while in the extended universe, and then they bring him back.
And it's just like, fuck, guys, come on. Like, if you're gonna get rid of that shit, like, at least use your original
At least actually
like,
get rid of
it. I don't think it's actually gonna be like I kind of suspect more it's gonna be like, it's like Luke's kid or something.
Or something dumb, yeah.
Yeah, because
you know, fuck.
There's the whole thing he's been talking about, that my family has it, and,
yeah.
You know, bullshit like that, and he's got Vader's mask, and, you know, oh, yeah, I gotta fulfill our destiny or whatever and shit. Which, how did he get Vader's fucking mask? You know,
he burned it at the end of episode 6, remember?
Yeah.
Shut up, though. No.
But
also, the fucking broadsword lightsaber design is fucking stupid.
Yeah, just
like, really fucking dumb.
No, engage the brakes, though, R2. No, but engage the brakes,
engage
though.
Them, though.
I love how this elevator is, like, way, way bigger than Grievous' ship actually was.
I know. And like... The platform you're standing on that's supposed to be the elevator is comically huge for an elevator.
Fucking droids. I'm selling
you for scrap.
No, just...
Well, we were just playing Fallout.
Yeah. Cool. But yeah, I mean... At least I do like the... I haven't read into enough of, like, the character names, whatever the black guy's name is.
Yeah, that dude.
He seems like he could be a cool character. You know, a guy learning, like, just like Luke, you know, just figuring out about the Force. You know, it's kind of weird he was a stormtrooper, and,
considering they're all supposed to be clones.
Yeah, no, whatever. No, but now there were female stormtroopers, though. You just never knew about it.
Ugh.
Even though they were all clones.
Oh, shit, all those cosplayers were right.
Yeah, it's... fuck.
Oh my god.
You know, I'm all for being inclusive, guys, but not at the expense of fucking canon.
Yeah. I'm sorry. It's not that
especially when it's 100% established.
Yeah. It's not that I don't want there to be female stormtroopers. It's just that, like, there aren't because Jango Fett was a guy.
And, like, it's fine in the new movies. That's fine. But, like, when I was playing Battlefront beta.
Yeah.
Like, some of the stormtroopers on Hoth were female in that game.
That's not how that works.
It's just like,
yeah, if you want the First Order to have established that, like, you know, now we recruit people and don't use clones or whatever, and, like, we want to join, fine, I'll buy it. But yeah,
and, like, conscription and
yeah,
and
sure,
shit. Yeah, like,
I'll buy that. I'll buy that.
But, like, that was never mentioned in the movies, and everything that wasn't in the movies is non canon now. So
yeah, like,
uh oh, we're about to become a lot
thinner. It's so bad. I love it.
Back into the car.
There's no time to argue. Go.
There are two holes. It's
fine. Well, yeah. I just love how they're both being assholes for no reason.
Well, that was their
next
thing.
Time we're taking the stairs.
That was their thing. Is they were
fucking love Obi-Wan.
He's
so much.
Great. He's so good. I love Obi-Wan Kenobi. He's awesome. Spoiler alert.
Yeah. Spoilers.
Implying that someone who hasn't seen the movies would ever play this game.
Steve bought the strategy guide with this.
The strategy guide.
Oh, actually, now that I think about it, the cover of the game is the
has
them
dueling.
On
yeah. Well, because well, actually, hold on. I have my Blu-ray collection of Star Wars: The Complete Saga over here. Let's see. I think the cover has it.
Yeah.
Oh God. There
oh
goes.
God. Oh boy.
That's gonna call up on the mic.
Oh, it's fine. It's fine. Everything's fine.
Let's see what we got
oh
here.
Oh boy, time to fight Count Sudoku.
Count Sudoku.
Yeah.
Yeah, look,
yeah, just,
you open up my fucking Blu-ray collection and it has them dueling on Mustafar.
It's just there. Alright, time for the first duel. The duels in this game are actually kind of tough.
Well, that's
if
good.
I remember right. Count Sudoku.
But,
Yeah, Plinkett's review of this where he's talking about, like, guys, how did you not know Sidious was a Sith Lord? Like, everything he says just gives it away.
Well, like, my favorite part is, you know, with the movie and everything. So after this whole duel happens, and then Anakin's sitting there, like, you know, constantly executing Dooku, and he literally says in Darth Sidious' voice, "Do it."
Yeah. Like, rip in peace, Christopher Lee.
Oh, what a man!
What a fucking hero.
Christopher Lee is the man I want to be when I grow up.
Yeah.
Oh. Man lived into his fucking mid-90s, continued to make metal at that age.
Yeah. He slayed 1,000 sacks of ice.
Yes. He's been in... I'm pretty sure... I don't think it's changed. I'm pretty sure the last time I looked, he held the world record for the most film roles.
Yeah.
You know, he's been in... He's been in almost 300 films.
He is fucking me up. Is that the best you have?
Yeah. Christopher Lee was the man. He played Count Dooku, a character I really love from the Star Wars universe, which no longer matters because a lot of that stuff isn't shown in the movies.
Yeah.
He plays Saruman, my favorite character from Lord of the Rings.
Oh, fucker. He got me with the shunt. Yeah, that's the one thing about this game's mechanics. I don't know how to do the lightsaber, like, blocking shit.
Yeah.
Like, you have to block and, like, hit the opposite direction.
Oh, that's kind of weird. Yeah, that's like some really Revengeance parry bullshit.
I've never gotten it there. I think I might have just gotten it the worst there. But it's some jank shit.
Yeah.
Just gotta
beam struggle.
You're running out of limbs. I love everyone talking shit about Anakin.
Oh, it's so great. It's so great. Give it up. You're no match for my skills. Well, it's like that comic I showed on Facebook a while ago. Nice suit, Vader. It must have cost you an arm and a leg.
Well, arms and legs.
Yeah.
But, everyone getting fucking sucker punched yet again.
Always the case.
Always getting bullshit. Yep.
Fuck.
Because Anakin couldn't hold Dooku. Now he gets incapacitated for the whole fight. Because fuck. Yep, just lovingly stare at each other for a couple seconds.
Yep, it's fine. That's how duels work. Yep. But yeah, it's so obvious that Palpatine is the fucking Sith Lord. Like,
yeah, what? Do a Psycho Crusher real quick, Anakin.
Yeah. That's cool that the railing's getting cut.
I
think it's a really cool environmental effect, actually.
Yeah, they
for 2005, that's actually very impressive, thinking about it.
They put a lot of work into this fucking thing. Like, it's for a port of, like, a licensed game.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
That's impressive.
And actually decent choreography to, like,
the
animation shit. They did some shit. Yeah, now here is where he does the bullshit.
But,
Oh, you fucker.
But yeah, it's super obvious that Palpatine's evil. It's great.
Yeah.
What I always loved is it's the same actor.
Yeah.
Because like in episode 6, he's just wearing a shitload of prosthetics
and shit.
And I think that's really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, because Palpatine is one of my favorite characters from Star Wars.
Oh, that's it. Nice.
Yeah. Fuck him up.
Woo. Oh, you fucker.
Count Dooku with his fucking fencing saber.
Yeah.
You know, form 2. Doesn't matter. Non-canon. Lightsaber forms are never mentioned in the movie.
Yeah. Oh, you fucking bitch. God damn. Dude, these fights are actually, like, kind of...
Yeah, I'm gonna say, it looks like it, like, actually requires effort.
Well, yep. Anakin's totally not evil, guys.
Don't worry about it.
Totally not evil,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, look at this fucking evil walk. Like,
totally not evil. I don't know what you're talking about. Do it.
The look that Count Dooku gives him when he says that is so priceless.
Yeah.
That shitty Ingrid comes up.
He's not evil, guys. Don't worry
about it. You're a disgrace to the Order. Excellent farm. Yeah, and so like, and that's the thing is like, Palpatine like talks about all that bullshit. Like, why does the fucking Grand Chancellor know about sword fighting techniques?
Why do you know all this shit that you shouldn't know? What the fuck?
Like when he tells Anakin the story about his own fucking Sith master, it doesn't throw off any red flags, like...
Yeah, I'm just gonna give it to the dark side a little bit.
Fuck it.
Just give him the dank side.
Epic foreshadowing maneuver.
Look at the fucking terrible skybox in the back, but then the actual 3D models coming in front.
I know, that's
super
so,
weird.
It's so dumb, it's super jarring. But it's cool that they have all that action going on, like, behind
circle
it.
Circle is an attack button, shit.
Oh, wow. It's cool to have all that action going on, like, in the background. Again, for 2005, you don't see that a lot.
Yeah.
You know, as good as...
Oh,
jeez. Yeah, watch yourself there.
Getting a little
ballsy.
Oh, give me the shunt.
Give you the elbow. Give you the bow.
Thumbos. Not impressed. Dark side.
Dark side, not impressed, he says, after just shooting Force Lightning.
Yeah.
Where were you aiming at?
I don't know. Sometimes the aiming's a little... Yeah, come here, fucker.
He's, like, staring at the camera doing that.
Back off, old man.
Whoa, calling him old and shit. just massive shit-talking in a saber duel is great.
It's so good.
Oh, I got you.
That's hilarious. It's Magic Pixel.
Yeah.
Well, no, the shit talking must occur for the Dunmach, the complete domination of your opponent.
Yeah. does it make? Yeah. Oh, I think I forgot about this.
Do you have to do the entire fight again?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what really makes the boss fights fucking terrible. Is yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, gotta do it
Guess
in one.
What's getting caught?
Yep. Can and will. Oh my god, ass kicked. Alright, here we go. Let's try. Oh god. Oh god. No, just die immediately.
just
die immediately.
Just get body.
There
oh
we go.
God.
Yep. This is the only thing that sucks about this game is how bad the checkpointing is for these duels. Actually, now that I think about it though, I think. I'm pretty sure one of them, or a couple of them, have a checkpoint in the middle of them.
Surrender while you can.
Because some of them are like these transitional ones in like different arenas, but like I think one or two of them is just one arena. Anytime, Obi-Wan. Anytime you'd like to help. No. Just keep getting hit.
Oops, all botch.
Yeah, it's fine.
That matrix of dodge bullshit right there.
No, but you use the force though. Yeah, throw your ass into a chair, you old prick. What are you gonna do now? Yeah, get it. You're finished, doo-doo.
I'll bet you didn't see that coming.
This there we go.
Count doo-doo.
You'll pay for that, Dooku.
You'll need the extra strength of your anger.
You're all alone now, Skywalker.
How is your arm
healing? Yeah, shit talking to you. That's great. Oh my god, fuck off. That fucking attack was bullshit and you know it, game.
Jesus.
Get fucking crushed.
This is for Obi-Wan.
This is for Obi-Wan. Yep, get launched. Just get juggled. There we go. That fucking. I'm not fucking around now. Oh boy. Oh, okay, yeah, he'll just drain meter on me. Yeah, get super asshole. Just throw out roll supers. It's
yeah, it's fine, don't worry about it.
Oh, fucking crazy.
The effects are really good on anything that you like cut off, like enemies and shit. The cauterization effects are actually really well done.
Oh, we're gonna fucking dodge me with this bullshit.
Don't force me to kill you.
Oh, I missed. What a cunt.
The exchange of force lightning right there was super flaccid.
Dumb, yeah. I just gotta be more patient. That's the problem. I keep fucking up. Okay, here we go.
It's like FromSoft games. Don't get greedy.
There we go.
Why is it Duel of the Fates every fight song?
Yeah.
Your speeches are beginning to bore me, Dooku.
That's what I should be doing. I should be modding Dark Souls and Dark Souls 2, so instead of playing boss fight music, it just always plays Duel of the Fates. Or at least on like the humanoid duels. Which is every Dark Souls 2 boss.
Yeah.
Hey.
Oh my god, he'd saber shunned me twice in a fucking
That's
round.
Fucked.
Yeah, that's great camera. That's great camera work. Of the dank side.
You are not yet concluded. You're facing the wrath of the dank side.
Oh yeah, I forgot you can do force healing.
I don't find it fair that the Sith can do force healing. I mean, I guess he used to be a Jedi, so it's a bit different.
Yeah, that's...
And see, the problem that they get into by making all the extended universe stuff non-canon is we don't get the bullshit that is Sith sorcery.
You gonna heal, fucker? I'll heal too. I'll heal all fucking day. Think I won't. He's really camping this fucking corner.
Yeah, he is. Holy
off.
Shit.
You'll never beat me.
Wow, that was a fucking cheap-ass hit he got on me.
Yeah, that's some bullshit. Come on.
No.
The fucking Palpatine.
Yeah.
There
got
you
him.
Go.
Wow, that face was terrible looking. But yeah, this one just has Anakin just cold-blooded murder him.
It works way better.
Which, yeah, and it doesn't foreshadow Palpatine being evil and, like... As if you didn't know it, but, yeah, like...
It's actually a way better narrative.
Yeah, that it establishes that Anakin is giving in to his hatred, like, instead of him being conflicted about it, like, he just straight up elects to just murder
him.
Well,
and that's why the Phantom Edit does that love story way better.
Yeah.
Because, you know, Padme doesn't die out of grief in that edit. She dies out of childbirth. And, like, the whole thing is, like... It's not that Anakin was manipulated. It's that, like, falling in love was his downfall.
Yeah.
Like,
that he couldn't control his emotions.
Yeah.
That's what made him a bad Jedi.
And that's what the narrative should have been.
Yeah.
Like, is that this really dumb bullshit we got? It's not over yet.
Yeah.